Hello students, we are at the meeting between King Magnus and the cabinet, and they have all collected here at the palace in order to serve an ultimatum to the king, which he has to comply with or do as the cabinet says. Essentially, the purpose behind the ultimatum is that the king's powers will be taken away from him so that all the power becomes vested in the cabinet under the leadership of Joe Proteus, who is the prime minister of the country. So, Proteus is speaking and he asks, "May I proceed?" And there is silence. Proteus says, "His Majesty asks whether the restriction on press campaigning is to be entirely one-sided." "That, I take it, sir, is your question?" Now, restriction means the limit on press campaigning is to be entirely one-sided. One-sided means only for the cabinet. That is, only the cabinet will be permitted to use the press for its campaigning. "Is this what you mean? That is your question?" Magnus nods and he says, "Yes." Proteus, "The answer is in the affirmative." Affirmative meaning the answer is yes, that the restriction will be one-sided in the sense that the king will not be permitted to use the press. Only the cabinet can make use of it. So Balbus, "Good. Anything more?" "Yes, one more thing. The veto must not be mentioned again. That can apply to both sides if you like. The veto is dead." We have understood what the word veto means. It means the power that somebody has, usually the person in authority has, to refuse something or to say no to something. Proteus is telling the king that he, the king, must never ever talk about the veto. He also says that can apply to both sides. You will not mention it and we, the cabinet, also will not mention it. The veto is dead. So Magnus asks, "May we not make a historical reference to the corpse?" We, he's talking as a king, so this is a symbol of royalty. Historical reference to the corpse. Basically, the word corpse means dead body. And which dead body is he talking about? The dead body of Veto. Can we not refer it, talk about it as something of the past, as a past tradition? So Proteus says, "No. I cannot carry on the king's government unless I can give pledges and carry them out." Pledges means formal promise or agreement to something. That is, unless and until I, as the prime minister, makes formal promises and I am able to fulfill those promises, unless I do that, how will I be able to run the king's government? Now notice, the king's government means in name, even today, the head of the country will be the king. But as it has been mentioned before, he will be in name only. In other words, a tutorial head of the country. What is my pledge worth if our constituents are reminded every day that the king may veto anything that parliament does? Naturally. If I make promises to the public, constituents means the voting public, and I am not able to fulfill those promises, why? Because the king says no to every law or bill that the parliament passes, then how can the cabinet function? What is my pledge worth if our constituents are reminded every day that the king may veto anything that parliament does? If the king says no to everything, we will not be able to function. Do you expect me to say when I am asked for a pledge, you must ask the king? That is, since I don't have the power, the king has the power to veto. Go and ask him. Is that what you expect me to respond to the public? So Magnus asks, I have to say, you must ask the prime minister. So instead, you cannot tell the public that you must ask the king. I, on the other hand, have to say, you must ask the prime minister. By doing this, the prime minister very efficiently is undermining the authority of the king. Whereas remember, the prime minister is a subject of the king. The king is supposed to be all powerful, but all powers are being taken away from him. Pliny consoling him. See, Pliny is a nice person, and so he's consoling him. Consoling means he's comforting the king. The effort is to make someone happier. To make someone happier when he's sad or disappointed. So Pliny says, that is the constitution, you know. This is what the law is, that you have to ask the prime minister. Magnus, quiet. Yes, I only mention it to show that the prime minister does not really wish to kill the veto. He only wishes to move it next door. In other words, the king is very smart. Magnus has understood. What the prime minister is trying to do is, he is taking away the power of veto which is vested in the king, and he will be using it for himself. This is what the king means when he says he only wishes to move it next door. And who is next door? The prime minister. That is, the king will not be able to use it any longer. The prime minister can. So Proteus very smartly answers, the people live next door. Now look how the chain is working. The cabinet member ministers and the prime minister have been elected by the public, the people, the voting public. So they live next door, it is their decision. The name on the brass plate is public opinion. Brass plate means the, outside any home or chamber, there is a plate which mentions the name of who sits inside. So it is public opinion. Magnus, very gravely, very seriously, admirably turned, Mr. Prime Minister, but unreal. Turned means expressed, very well expressed, Mr. Prime Minister, but it is unreal. What you say is not real. That is, I am far more subject to public opinion than you, because thanks to the general belief in democracy, you can always pretend that what you do is done by the will of the people. In other words, that since the ministers and the prime minister have been elected by the public, they can always convince the public that whatever they decide to do or whatever action plan they follow, it is what the public wants. Why? Because the public is innocent. It is naive, it is gullible. Naive means N-A-I-V, naive. And gullible, gullible means innocent. It will easily believe whatever it is told. In other words, the king is trying to tell them that it is on your suggestion that the public forms an opinion. Why? Because it is gullible, it cannot think for itself. The public is innocent, it does not have a mind of its own, so it will believe whatever the cabinet tells us. And who, God knows, never dreamt of it. The public never imagined doing anything and would not have understood it if they had. Even if the public had decided to do something, they would not have been able to understand why they are doing it. Whereas for what a king does, he and he alone is held responsible. That is, on the other hand, whatever a king does is ultimately his single responsibility. A demagogue may steal a horse where a king dare not look over a hedge. Now, a demagogue, please write the meaning. A political leader who seeks support by appealing to the wishes and prejudices, PREJUDICES, prejudices of ordinary people, rather than using sensible or logical argument, sensible or logical argument. कहने का मतलब ये है that और ये political leaders की चाल होती है कि वो public sentiment को उकसाते हैं और ऐसा करके वो अपनी बात मनवा लेते हैं. जबकि there is the king dare not even look over the hedge, यानी कि boundary के पार पड़ोसी की तरफ वो झांक भी नहीं सकते, देख भी नहीं सकते, लेकिन जो political leaders होते हैं वो मनमानी कर सकते हैं. they can do as they please. Lysistrata, I doubt that it is any longer true, sir. I know that I get blamed for everything that goes wrong in my department. अब Lysistrata का experience कुछ और है, so वो कह रही है कि मुझे नहीं लगता कि आप जो कह रहे हैं वो अब सही है. क्यों? कि मेरे डिपार्टमेंट में अगर कोई गड़बड़ होती है, इफ़ एनी थिंग गोज रॉन्ग देन आई एम ब्लेम फॉर इट. सो मैग्नस, आ बट वॉट अ डेस्पॉट यू आर Lysistrata. डेस्पॉट, यू आर सच अ क्रूअल रूलर, यू रूल विथ एन आयरन हैंड. ग्रांटेड हाउएवर, ग्रांटेड मीन्स आई एक्सेप्ट दैट द पीपल हैव फाउंड आउट लॉन्ग अगो दैट डेमोक्रेसी इज हम्बग. Humbug means false talk, a trick to fool the public. That is, जनता को बहुत पहले ही पता चल गया था, समझ में आ गया था कि ये जो गणतंत्र या प्रजातंत्र जिसकी बात करते हैं वो केवल एक तरीका है जनता को बेवकूफ़ या मूर्ख बनाने का, to trick the or to fool the public. And that instead of establishing responsible government, it has abolished it. Abolished means to end something, to end a law or a system officially. Responsible government को establish करने की बजाय democracy ने क्या किया है, responsible government को ख़त्म कर दिया है. It has ended it. Bonajus is scandalized, he's shocked. Steady, I cannot sit here and listen to such a word as humbug being applied to democracy. I'm sorry sir, but with all respect to for you, I really must draw the line at that. Draw the line means set a limit. Set a limit on what one is willing to accept. Set a limit on what one is willing to accept, to do or not. Yani ki I'm sorry sir, ye king se kaha ja raha hai, but you cannot use that word humbug for democracy. So Magnus answers, you are right Mr. Bonajus, as you always are. Very smartly the king in these two words, as you always are, he has won Mr. Bonajus over, that aap hamesha sahi bolte hain. Democracy is a very real thing with much less humbug about it than many older institutions. But it means not that the people govern, but that the responsibility and the veto now belong neither to kings nor demagogues as such, but to whoever is clever enough to get them. So he says, yes, what I am trying to say is that janta sarkar ko nahi chalati hai, but the responsibility of running the government and the power of veto now are not in the hands of kings or any political leader, but in the hands of whoever is clever enough to get them. And who is he referring to? A man like Proteus. So Lysistrata says, yourself, sir, for example, you are smart and clever enough. So Magnus says, I think I am in the running. In the running means I am a possible candidate. That is why I do not feel bound to accept this ultimatum. That is, I don't think that I ought to do something. Bound means I don't think I ought to do this, which is accept the ultimatum. Why? Because by signing it, I put myself out of the running. I'm putting myself out of the contest. Why should I do that? अब तक तो मैं भी सरकार का एक हिस्सा था, बट अगर मैंने अल्टीमेटम साइन कर दिया, इफ़ आई साइन द अल्टीमेटम, देन आई विल नो लॉन्गर बी वन ऑफ द पॉसिबल कैंडिडेट्स टू रूल द कंट्री, बैल्बस, बिकॉज यू आर द किंग, दैट इज़ वाई. सो मैग्नस आस्क्स, डज इट फॉलो, जस्ट बिकॉज आई एम किंग डू आई हैव टू साइन द अल्टीमेटम? सो प्रोटियस आंसर्स, इफ़ टू मैन राइड द सेम हॉर्स then one must ride behind. यानी कि अगर एक ही घोड़े पर दो जने बैठे हैं तो एक को पीछे बैठना पड़ेगा. In other words, the reins will be in the hands of the man sitting in front. Reins means वो जो चमड़े की लगाम होती है घोड़े को कंट्रोल करने के लिए, जो आगे बैठा होता है उसी के हाथ में लगाम होती है. So one has to ride behind. So Lysistrata asks, which? Proteus, turning to her sharply, what was that you said? What did you say? Lysistrata, with placid but formidable obstinacy and ironical explicitness. Means very calmly. Placid means calmly, but formidable means inducing fear, stubbornly. She very clearly expresses herself and she says, I said which? You said that if two men rode the same horse, one of them must ride behind. I said which? Then she explains, which man must ride behind? Which of you will sit behind? In other words, who will be the leader? You, the Prime Minister, or Magnus, the King? Got it, Joe? Have you understood, Joe? Proteus, that is exactly the question that has to be settled here and now. And what is the question? Who will be the leader? In whose hands will the power be? Who will rule or lead the country? So Amanda, once and for all, these are the words that Proteus uses whenever he is dictating some news. So this is his pet phrase. Everybody laughs except Proteus, who rises in a fury. He's very angry. And he says, I will not stand this perpetual tomfooling. Perpetual means constant. And tomfooling means foolish, stupid behavior. I will not allow you to do this. He's very annoyed. I had rather be a dog than the Prime Minister of a country where the only things the inhabitants can be serious about are football and refreshments. That is, I would prefer being a dog. I would prefer. Than to be the Prime Minister of a country where the public, the people are only worried about two things. They are only serious or interested in two things. One are football matches and the other is enjoying refreshments or snacks. Lick the boots or the king's boots, that is all you are fit for. Lick the king's boots means behave in a servile manner. S-E-R-V-I-L-E, servile manner. When one is excessively willing to serve others. That is all you are fit for. And he rushes out of the room. You've done it now, Mandy. I hope you are proud of yourself. Balbus prompts her. It is you, Amanda, who should go and coax him back. That is, you should go and bring him back. Coax him back means persuade him to come back. But then he says, but I suppose I must do it myself as usual. Excuse me, ladies and gentlemen. And he stands up to leave. Everybody else stands up. That is protocol. And he goes out. Bonajus, I told you what would come of conducting a conference with His Majesty as if it were a smoking concert. I'm disgusted. Now he throws himself back into his chair. A smoking concert. Please write the meaning. A live performance with music for men only during the Victorian era, where men would smoke and talk politics while listening to music. Okay, conference means meeting. So they are all annoyed with Amanda, basically. And he throws himself into his chair. Balbus says, we had just cornered the old fox. Old fox means the cunning fellow. He's talking about the king. And then Amanda must have her silly laugh and lets him out of it. That is, we had just pushed him into a corner. He would have said yes. And Amanda with her laugh allows him to escape. Nicobar, what are we to do now? That is what I want to know. So Amanda, incorrigible as always. Incorrigible means she's beyond correction. Nobody can control her. I suggest a little community singing. And she makes conductor-like gestures. Conductor here means the music director who guides the musicians through a piece of music. So let us all have a group song. Nicobar, yeah. And he sits down sulkily. He's also angry. He refuses to smile. Amanda sits down with a little splutter of laughter. But Crassius, thoughtfully, he says, take it easy, friends. Relax, friends. Joe knows what he is about. Joe knows what he is doing. He did it deliberately. Of course he does. I can excuse you, Bill, because it is your first day in the cabinet. That is, of course, the Prime Minister knows what he is doing. You can be forgiven, Bill, for not understanding the reasons behind the Prime Minister's behavior. But if the rest of you have not found out by this time that Joe's rages are invariably calculated, then nothing will ever teach you anything. And she sits down contemptuously. Now, rages means fits of anger. Invariably, always, without fail. Always without fail. Calculated means deliberate, with a purpose. Except for Bill Boanerges, this is what Lysistrata is trying to say, except for Bill Boanerges, for whom it is the first time that he is attending cabinet, all the others have been here for many years. So they should know that every time Joe goes into a fit of anger, there is always a deliberate purpose behind it. Boanerges, in his grandest manner, well, madam, I know I am a newcomer. Everything must have a beginning. I am open to argument and conviction. Conviction means being explained something, having a strong opinion. If you explain things to me, I will understand. The Prime Minister brought this conference. Brought called this meeting, in which I admit was a very able and resolute manner to the verge of a decision. Resolute means determined. He organized this meeting in a very determined way, and we had almost reached a decision. Then, in a fit of childish temper, he breaks up the conference, leaving us looking like fools with nothing done. Why did he do this? Bill fails to understand. And you tell me he did it on purpose? Where was the advantage to him in such a display? Answered me that. In other words, what could he possibly gain by displaying such behavior? Tell me this. Lysistrata. He is settling the whole business with the king behind our backs. That is what Joe always contrives to do. Contrives to do means tries to do. That is, he and the king by themselves are deciding this issue. He always tries to do that by hook or crook. This is the prime minister's typical technique. By hook or crook means anyhow, by foul or fair means, Joe tries to have a meeting alone with the king. Pliny, you didn't arrange it with him, Mandy, did you? Arrange, plan it with the prime minister, did you? So Amanda answers, there wasn't any need to arrange it. Joe can always depend on one or other of us saying something that will give him an excuse for flying out. Flying out means leaving in a hurry. We always say or do something which makes him pretend as if he's very angry with us and he rushes out. Crassus. In my opinion, ladies and gentlemen, we have done our bit. We have done our bit means we have played our role, whatever we were supposed to do. That is, we have done our share of the work and may leave the rest to Joe. Matters had reached a point at which it was yes or no between the cabinet and the crown. There is only one sort of committee that is better than a committee of two, and that is a committee of one. In other words, if one person can decide something, there is no need for two people to reach the decision. Like the family in Wordsworth's poem, we are seven. So Lysistrata checks him. Eight. Well, seven or eight, we were too many for the final grapple. Final grapple, to get hold of something and fight, to try to control something. That is, whenever something has to be decided, if too many people are involved, then reaching any decision is almost impossibly difficult. It is better if two people work it out between them. Two persons sticking to the point are worth eight all over the shop. So my advice is that we just sit here quietly until Joe comes back and tells us what has been settled. That is, these two will work it out, the Prime Minister and the King. Perhaps Amanda will oblige with a song, and he resumes his seat. Oblige us here means entertain us. You can entertain us with a song. Just then the king returns with Proteus, who looks glum, means sad. All rise. The two resume their seats in silence. The rest sit down. Okay, we'll take a break here. Continue in the next session. Thank you.